two off. Ferocious Warriors out. It was a punishing second kick, wasn't it?
Back up to the standing position. Nice roll by Eduard Folayang. Beautiful hip toss.
Totally at ease with everything that's just happened. This is the noisiest crowd I've experienced at a one championship event, and they are absolutely loving this.
His wits about him. He mixes in a lot of different styles. Oh, look at Folayang spinning already.
Big left hook there, smack bang from Folayang. Plenty of action from Folayang. Oh, spinning back fist. Inside leg kick. Here comes Folayang. And Amir closes him down. Champagne from Folayang! Ah, boom shakalaka! Boom shakalaka! Here comes Folayang! It's a meltdown in Manila!
Huge, huge round!
A beautiful knee to the midsection! The Filipino fury of Eduard Folayang! Spinning back elbow! Smack bang! And again! This is crazy! Both men trade, and it was Khan who drew the short straw. Spinning hook kick! Has he got a big time? Oh, flying kick!
Detailing gold medalist.
Oh, that McCann touched him. Zachary's top of the head.
Oh, the side kick!
Nice little step up the line, turning back and forth the line.
It doesn't matter what legs forward.
Oh, spinning hook kick!
Folayang cuts off the cage and almost cuts off his head with that side kick.
And now the ground and pound for the former world champion.
Two-punch combination.
Give himself a little bit of encouragement. The attack from Aoki.
There's that flying knee again. That is getting timed very well. But look at this. He's able to shrug.
Oh,
off
and the knee to the head
down
as well.
Oh,
and Folayang has got Shinya in trouble. Punches to the head. The noise behind me is deafening. Folayang looking for the finish. Shinya Aoki is standing very, very closely, watching hard. Nothing's coming back from Aoki. We're only half a minute into this third round. It's perpetual motion from the Filipino. And it is all over. We have a new one championship lightweight title holder. And his name is Eduard Folayang.
Eduard Folayang shocks the world!
Great crowd, very noisy. This is what they came for. Right hands from Folayang early on, wanting to land those big punches as soon as he can before Aoki can get to grips with him.
Immediately, Aoki comes open-handed, no strikes thrown, gets into the clinch. And it is no surprise that he wants this fight as quickly as he can to the ground.
Strong man for Folayang, tough to get him to the ground. He'll rely on technique, just as he did there. Now, how good is Folayang's submission defense? And can he get back onto his feet where he'll be more dangerous?
Aoki is so strong from these positions. Once he gets those hands on you, it's just like he has clasped, like he's just magnetized to your body. He keeps such tight pressure in every inch that he slides his body that he easily passes into side control, laces the hands. He's got deceptively long limbs. He's got a great reach, and he easily slides around. Nice, but he jumps onto the back of Folayang. They're dry too, there's no sweat on the body, so it's a lot harder to slip out of these positions. Folayang is very explosive. He likes to burst into positions, but Aoki's dry, so he's clinging onto the back like a koala bear.
They're directly above us here at cage side. Good strength from Aoki.
Armbar, possible armbar here. It looks like he's going for it. It looks like he's setting up a Kimura now. Taking the back, he uses it to hold onto the position. Now he's got the back and the body triangle.
Folayang will have trained for these kind of positions intensively over the past few weeks.
Yeah, but you just don't know if he has the caliber of grappler out there in Baguio like Shinya Aoki.
I think it's inevitable that he doesn't have it. This is the real thing. This is the biggest test for him.
And even if he does have great grapplers in his camp, they're not going to be able to emulate the style that Aoki has. He's so unique, he's so versatile, and he's so different, he's so creative. Nobody in the world is like Shinya Aoki.
This fight being beamed to 118 countries around the world. Tremendous level of interest in this contest. The flagship of one championship in many ways, Shinya Aoki. Mitch, you've fought and grappled with, trained with Shinya Aoki before. You haven't fought him as such, but you've trained with him so many hours. Just how tough is it?
Yeah, Steve, I've spent hours on the mat with this guy, and I don't last very long. I don't last as Edward's doing a great job, and he's able to slide out.
And he's back on his feet, and that's where
impressive.
He wants to be. Great impetus for Folayang fans now. What can he do with this opportunity?
That's a victory all unto itself, but now he's going to have to be very careful. Ooh, he jumps into a nice little knee there. He should have circled around and created more space because Aoki immediately goes to the clinch. He's got those hips laced up, so Folayang really can't go anywhere, and he uses a beautiful body lock, trip takedown. And now Folayang's up against the cage.
He's okay.
1 minute 30 left of this opening round. Most of it has been on the deck with Aoki in charge. Elbow to the head of Folayang.
Folayang was able to get back into guard, a better position for him, not as much danger, pushes off.
Great strength again from the Filipino.
Look how tight he immediately magnetizes himself to Folayang, letting him go nowhere.
Thrives on the contact, the Japanese fighter, doesn't he? Doesn't want any space between you and him.
Folayang's doing a good job. He's got to break this body lock. You don't want to let your opponent get double underhooks and get that tight body lock, because Shinya's probably going to end up going to a trip here and drag Folayang back down to the mat. You can see him trying to pick him up, but Folayang maintain a good base.
Five rounds this one, potentially. Don't forget, championship contest.
Judges will score the bout in its entirety
and not round by round. We'll go to Rich Franklin when this one's done to get his thoughts on the first 5 minutes.
Good balance shown by Folayang because he went for that outside trip there, and Folayang was able to maintain his balance and stay on his feet. And he's actually looks like he's going to get out of the first round after some very dangerous. The entire hush has fallen over the Singapore Indoor Stadium as this packed crowd is just waiting for
good trip.
Beautifully timed. Right as Folayang was throwing that knee, Aoki swept that foot out and just scored with another takedown. We can see here's Aoki threatening with a possible kimura, was able to maintain that position with the kimura using those long legs to secure the back and just jump on there with that body triangle. It's probably pretty evident how this round has been scored, but let's go to Rich Franklin, just get his opinion on what's happening so far.
Yeah, obviously this fight is all about the ground control. Aoki is taking control with the takedowns. He's controlling Folayang on the ground, but Folayang has showed some glimpses, and this is what I talked about before the fight. He's very unorthodox. He works himself out of weird positions, which is a very difficult thing to do against a guy like Aoki. After all, you've had him on top of you, and you know what it's like. So it's going to be interesting because Aoki has been pressure in the first round, and I wonder if that's going to actually affect his gas tank at all. And, Folayang, he'll stay unorthodox the whole fight, and we're going to see if that actually poses some problems in the later rounds. At this point, if the fight was stopped, obviously Aoki.
We're only one-fifth of the way through this contest as scheduled, though. And those Baguio trainers training at altitude are very, very fit. Cardio is a big deal for them.
Looks like a kick was the first strike that Aoki has thrown this entire fight.
Folayang trying to confuse with movement laterally, side to side, changing direction constantly.
That's
a moving target.
That's what he's doing. But he's a.
Whoa! Really let go with that kick, and there was the familiar spinning back fist. Didn't connect.
He can't help it. He's put himself into a dangerous position when he spins by giving the back to Aoki like that. But he says he can't help it. It's just something that naturally happens. He loves the spinning attacks. That's good, that's good. Looked like it was a possible headbutt to the chin there. Yuji Shimada is warning Folayang about it.
Whenever Aoki shoots for the takedown, he's got to be careful of knees and all sorts of things coming at him, because Folayang will have trained for that. Land those blows when you can.
Good movement. Aoki's trying to pressure Folayang up against the cage. Folayang's got to start moving. He can't let him get that close.
He's an expert at just cutting you off, isn't he, Aoki?
He's cutting beautiful corners. Nice defense there from Eduard as he throws off the double leg attempt from Aoki.
Great strength from the Filipino to do that. He's got tree trunk legs, as so many of the fighters in Baguio do. Training in those hills. Tremendous strength in the lower limbs. That was just, just everything was thrown into that. It didn't land, but it nearly knocked Aoki over just with the draft.
I'm liking the lateral movement of Folayang. He's moving really well on his feet. He's just not putting any strikes behind it, so he's not scoring. He's not hurting Aoki, except with these big, scary strikes, which I think I can kind of feel the wind from over here. Oh, nice little knee, but again, he gives himself into the takedown.
It was a very ambitious effort, wasn't it, from Eduard? He was always going to expose himself if it didn't pay off.
High-risk move with huge payoff capabilities, but now he's on the mat with one of the world's greatest.
Approaching the midway point in the second round. One championship, lightweight title on the line. The champion in the white shorts, the challenger in the red.
Aoki's doing the right thing. He's pushing him up against the cage, dropping him with those elbows. He's not only scoring points, but he's also softening up Eduard. Folayang's trying to create some kind of space. And that's exactly what he's able to do.
Oh,
but Aoki
he's done
just
well.
Immediately latches onto him.
Back on his feet, Folayang, but
that's
still
it.
Not out of trouble.
It's better than where he was. So that's improvement.
Knees to the body from the Filipino. Ideally, he wants space between the two of them so that he can attack with legs and punches, but these knees to the body will be punishing.
Nice knees from Folayang. He scored a bit there and was able to break away. These might be moral victories for Folayang, but I don't know if the judges score on survival.
Five rounds, it's a marathon, not a sprint. Folayang knows that if he can just keep surviving, the chances will come.
But you can see Aoki's not expending any energy. He's completely relaxed into every single one of these positions that he gets into, and Folayang's not landing any strikes that are doing any significant damage to Aoki yet.
Contrastingly, in the stand-up, Folayang expending a lot of energy, lots of lateral movement.
That was a nice little lower leg kick there thrown by Folayang. Aoki acknowledged it well. He was like, yeah, you got me.
Aoki almost static at times. So focused, is he?
He's just waiting for the takedown. You know what Aoki's going to do. He's going to get to the clinch, try to get the takedown, but can you stop it? That's the question. That's the puzzle everybody's been trying to solve in one championship.
Oh, kick to the knee from Eduard. Hard feet. He's got hard shins.
He needs to keep doing that over and over again, attacking those legs, because that's going to limit the movement of Aoki.
The strength of that punch. Aoki backed off. Just hit him in the chest, I think. Oh, but there we go again. Again, it was low. There's the spinning back kick. Getting a bit of momentum now. The
nice
kick to the torso. The crowd getting behind Folayang. There'll be plenty of Filipinos here in Singapore. Punch to the body. Is that an area of potential weakness for Shinya? And Eduard Folayang ends the second round on the up and up.
That was a better round for Folayang. He was able to use the strikes and start to open up. And he's really starting to dictate the space. There's that big head kick and spinning back that they just barely missed. big attempt. Good, he stopped the takedown. These are moral victories. These are going to add to his confidence. You can see Folayang immediately gets into guard, keeps him nice and tight. Rich Franklin, what do you got so far?
Well, I'll tell you, Folayang had a couple takedown defenses in that round. They ended up on the ground, which wasn't a takedown by Aoki. However, Aoki added to his ground control lead. At the beginning of the round, it was really interesting to me because even though Folayang was moving side to side laterally, Aoki was moving in such a way that Folayang couldn't really commit to anything. He couldn't mount any damage on the feet. Anytime he committed, he knew he was going to end up on the ground. But at the end of that round there, you could see that Folayang was moving forward more and more, and Aoki was back. And at the end of that round, you could see that Folayang was landing the strikes. He closed the lead a little bit there, but still, if the fight was stopped at this point in time, Aoki would still have the decision.
I like what you're saying there, Mitch. Little moral victories here and there, confidence boosters for Folayang, just that he can bring forward. Give himself a little bit of encouragement. The attack from Aoki.
There's that flying knee again. That is getting timed very well. But look at this. He's able to shrug.
Oh, and the knee to the head as well. Folayang has got Shinya in trouble. Punches to the head. The noise behind me is deafening. Folayang looking for the finish. Shinya Aoki is standing very, very closely, watching hard. Nothing's coming back from Aoki. We're only half a minute into this third round. It's perpetual motion from the Filipino. And it is all over. We have a new ONE Championship lightweight title holder. And his name is Eduard Folayang.
He did it! Eduard Folayang shocks the world with an upset victory to become the new ONE Lightweight World Champion. Quite possibly the biggest upset we've ever had in ONE Championship.
Well, I tell you, there were a few people who could have seen it coming. Rich Franklin, give us your thoughts.
I don't even know what to say at this point in time. It's unbelievable, you know? Folayang had those high-risk moves, the spinning kicks, the spinning, and he actually attempted that jump knee once or twice earlier in the fight. And you knew that if it landed, it was going to pay off for him, and it paid off right there.
You can see from the replay, Aoki offering nothing in return, defending as best he could, but nothing was coming back, and that was the deciding factor in Yuji Shimada's decision to stop the fight. And the tears of emotion, so apparent. It's been a long time coming for Eduard Folayang, but his moment has arrived, and the Philippines are enjoying it just as much as he is.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 41 seconds in the third round. For your winner, and new ONE Lightweight World Champion, Eduard Folayang!
Well, I can barely see anything here at Cage Side because of what's falling from the skies.